This is the latest victim of a geopolitical struggle playing out on Iraqi soil. 18-year-old Zahra Hasab al-Nabi Othman was killed when rockets targeted the U.S. embassy in Baghdad. She's the eighth civilian to die in Iraq as a result of attacks between U.S. forces and Iranian-backed groups in recent months.
We don't know where these rockets are coming from, but the civilians are the victims. The problems are between America and Iran, and the residents are the victims.
During Tuesday's attack, the U.S. deployed a recently installed air defense system, also known as CRAM, to protect its fortified embassy. But civilians in nearby areas were not spared. This is the moment Zahra suffered fatal injuries just outside the entrance to a popular park in the center of the capital. The attack came minutes after the Trump administration announced a drawdown from 3,000 to 2,500 U.S. soldiers who've been stationed here since 2014 to fight ISIL.
We will finish this generational war and bring our men and women home. We will protect our children from the heavy burden and toll of perpetual war.
But the relatively minor troop reduction isn't enough for pro-Iranian armed groups.
We demand the withdrawal of all U.S. troops. We don't accept a single soldier to stay. The U.S. attempts to maneuver around Iraqi demands and the resolution of the Iraqi parliament.
Kataib Hezbollah, which is part of the so-called Islamic resistance, has been accused of targeting U.S. interests in the past. Last month, the group began a unilateral truce to give the U.S. a chance to meet demands for full troop withdrawal. Kataib Hezbollah denied any involvement in Tuesday's attack. While most Shia groups are keen to see the U.S. leave Iraq, Kurdish and Sunni politicians want them to remain. Kadhim al-Shamari is part of a Sunni bloc in parliament which boycotted a January vote to expel foreign troops.
The Iraqi army is not ready to confront all possible attacks from ISIL or others. Because of that, when it came to vote for the ousting of foreign troops, we believed that this resolution came in a rush.
The Iraqi government has said it wants to continue to cooperate with the U.S. on training and intelligence sharing.
Iraqis are divided about the presence of U.S. troops. Some see them as an occupying force, while others regard them as a necessary counterbalance to Iran's influence here. Others, again, fear that without the air, surveillance and intelligence support from the U.S.-led coalition, Iraqi security forces could face difficulties in containing ISIL's resurgence. Simona Foltyn, Al Jazeera, Baghdad.